tap dripping. I don't remember that. That's obviously a water torture vibe. It's got to be landing on Edge's head. Let's see. I don't know about you, I love one-shot videos where there's a lot going on. How the hell he managed to get through this, I'll never know. He looks great as well. I mean, working with you too, as you know, is a unique experience, and none more so than this particular one. They don't follow the rules. It's not a matter of submitting a treatment and shooting it in many cases. It's a matter of sitting around bullshitting, trying things on paper, talking about stuff, throwing stuff out. And you may be doing that till you're actually on the studio floor or actually on location. And in this case, that's exactly what happened. We were flown out to Berlin, as I recall. And all that we had at that stage was a notebook with a list in it. And we went to dinner with the band, and between courses, we sort of went through the list and said, well, why don't we try some feet in the face there, or strangling the face with a rope, or a bunch of roses. No, let's forget that. Let's try this. In other words, we had a bunch of ammunition and a cast standing by to try all sorts of things. The only thing that we really knew at that stage that was going to be a locked-off shot that was the point of view of a TV. You can imagine all the people waiting off screen to actually come in and do their little bits with ropes and... there's something very radio about this. It reminds me of, don't ask me why, War of the Worlds, Orson Welles' War of the Worlds, with people standing by with clapperboards and tins and things to do their special effects. Edge was incredible. I don't think he laughed in any take at all with all this mayhem happening around him and to him. Quite an achievement. There we go, into black. There was no idea for it at all, so we took the rather daring decision of actually having nothing on screen at all. I know there was a little bit of worry about that from various sources, but actually it's a magic moment. Finally, on MTV, for about 5 or 6 seconds, there's nothing happening. Just a flickering light, that doesn't really qualify as action, does it? And I was rather pleased about that. He's very good, actually, though, isn't he? And there is Adam. Okay, and they go off to do some kind of a covert deal in the background. I remember standing in the background with a huge notepad with almost like reading. That's probably why it reminds me of War of the Worlds, where Orson Welles was yelling out instructions or pointing at. Now, who's that? That's got to be Morley on the left, hasn't it? I mean, I may be wrong, but I think it's probably where he fell in love with Morley. The feet and the face, what can I say? I do hope they bathed. That is very silly. I remember they did a skit on this, didn't they? Somebody did a comedy version of this that was shown on some TV show in the States. I feel a big hairy hand coming in. And I think Morley will be shaking a tail feather in, as they say. That's a moment to treasure. A fan, another fan, and I think the DP, yes, Steve Chivers, stepped away from his camera, took a photograph, and I think Paul McGuinness is Edge, there's somebody I want you to meet.